Hi friends, and today we are going to discuss again from the depreciation accounting ICAI study material and illustration 3-2. Of course, illustration 10 we are going to discuss the problems, but of course out of these and annuity method and sinking fund method, and both they have been deleted from the ICAI syllabus, so that except those two, annuity and the sinking fund method, and we can discuss all the remaining problems, and of course till 10th today. Okay, and for all these the topics and whatever the topics I right now I uploaded videos for all of them, I provided the ICAI link, so that definitely, and all the students, all professional students like CMA, CS and even degree students and all others can watch these videos by taking the support of that link. And definitely accountancy will be the at CA level, and it will be normally you may find at the highest and at very tough level. Okay, so that if you prepare well at the CA level, and definitely it is useful to write all the examinations, CMA, CS and degree and all other examinations, and it will be sufficient. So, and you can take support of the ICAI link, whatever I provided there. And I believe that these videos will be useful to you, and definitely in a better way. Okay, so today I'm going to discuss these problems. First, let us go to the third illustration problem. It is sum of years of digits method. Sum of years of digits method. This sum of years of digits method is also very, very similar to the written down value or diminishing balance method. How in the diminishing balance method, depreciation will be heavy in the earlier years and it is quite less in the latter years. It is always in the decreasing pattern. So in the earlier years, the depreciation will be more. In the latter years, depreciation will be less. So depreciation will be decreasing year by year. Of course, even in this method also, depreciation will be in the decreasing manner, which is called sum of the years of digits method. First, I would like to say in the sum of years of digits method, annual depreciation formula. Annual depreciation is equal to cost of asset minus scrap value. Cost of asset minus scrap value. And this is what I can say, net cost of asset. This is also called as a depreciable amount, because scrap value, residual value not to be depreciated. Therefore, that is to be deducted every time. So cost of asset minus scrap value, which is depreciable amount, into, write in the numerator and denominator what you are going to see, that every time this is quite similar, but while writing in the numerator you are going to write that remaining lifetime of asset, remaining lifetime of asset in brackets including current year. Okay, cost of asset minus scrap value, annual depreciation is equal to cost of asset minus scrap value into, write in the numerator, asset remaining lifetime including the current year for which you would like to depreciate. Say example, asset lifetime 10 years. First year you want to depreciate. Write in the numerator 10, because including the present year, remaining lifetime is 10 years. How can you depreciate in the second, how can you write in the second year? 9 years, because including that year, remaining lifetime is 9. If you would like to write for depreciate last year, numerator 1, last but 1 year 2. So in that way, in the numerator you can write, so remaining lifetime of the asset including the current year, so divided by n into n plus 1 by 2. N into n plus 1 by 2, in the sense n means number of years, n into n plus 1 by 2, that is in the numerator you have to write this and this. These both will not be changed to depreciate in any year, but only what you write in the numerator and that only will be changed, and this will not be changed in any year to depreciate. This is a simple way to depreciate under sum of years of digits method, and of how, what kind of advantages you can have in the diminishing balance method. The same advantages you can have here also. And even here also, depreciation will be decreasing year by year. Okay, so now I'd like to solve the problem number illustration 3. Messrs. Akash purchased a machine 10 lakhs rupees, estimated useful life and 10 years, and scrap value is 1,20,000. The machine was put into usage 1/1/2010, but you are required to maintain the machinery account depreciation account for 2015. 2015 you need to maintain the depreciation, means already you put into usage that asset in 2010, 11, 12, 13, 14. Already the asset has been depreciated for 5 years. You need to maintain the machine account 6th year. And how to start the machinery account? First of all, I would like to come to know what is the depreciation for the past 5 years. From the cost of asset, we can depreciate all the past 5 years depreciation. Let us check the written down value at the beginning of 6th year. Let us bring that asset in the beginning of 6th year as a balance here. And we can let us work out the depreciation for the 6th year. The only 6th year you need to maintain the machinery account. Then I would like to know that total depreciation for the past 5 years. I would like to know. Come to the working notes. Working notes, the first point, total depreciation for 5 years, for the years 2010 to 2014, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 5 years. So need not to calculate every time like that. Let us do one thing. This won't be changed and this won't be changed. This will be changed year to year. Then you simply, you can work out all this. And cost of asset minus scrap value. In the sense, what we can say here, cost of asset is 10 lakhs minus scrap value given at 1,20,000. Net cost of asset into, in the denominator, n into n plus 1 by 2, it won't be changed. Every year it will be 10 into 10 plus 1 by 2. But in the numerator, in first year, you need to write 10. Need not to calculate the quite five number of times. So we can add all the year plus. For second year, you need to calculate by 9, by writing 9. Next year, 8, 7 and 6. That's all. So 10 plus 9 plus 8 plus 7 plus 6. So instead of doing this many number of times, you can write in the numerator of addition of all that. And directly, I am able to know depreciation, total depreciation for the past 5 years. So therefore, you may work out like this. 10 lakhs minus 1 lakh 80, 8 lakh 80 thousand into numerator. If you total that, and of course the total, and it will be 40. In the denominator, 10 plus 1, 11. 11 into 10, 110. 110 by 2, 55. Okay. And of course, that result is 6 lakhs 40 thousand. What I can say, total depreciation for the past 5 years is 6,40,000. And therefore, we can say written down value on 1/1/2015 is equal to, the cost of asset is 10 lakhs, total depreciated value 6,40,000, and therefore it would be 3,60,000. And that 3,60,000 I can bring here 1/1/2015 to balance, brought down 3,60,000. And I would like to depreciate for the current year. Depreciation for 2015. Depreciation for 2015. And simply you can write cost of asset minus scrap value 10 lakhs minus scrap value 1,20,000, net cost of asset 1,80,000 into, in the numerator you can write 5, because including the current year, remaining lifetime will be 5 years. In the denominator, common, 10 into 10 plus 1 by 2, therefore it will be 8,80,000 into 5/55. The result will be here is 80,000. This is the depreciation for current year. So depreciation account data to asset account, in the asset by depreciation. $80,000. That's all, nothing else, just you can balance it, 3,60,000. 3,60,000 by balance carry down 2,80,000 by balance carry down, and 1/1/2016 2 balance brought down 2,80,000. Moreover, in the machinery by depreciation, in the depreciation to machinery, $80,000, and this must be charged to P&L as a non-cash expenditure or transferred to P&L. So by P&L account $80,000. So this is the simple way to solve the sum of the digits method. Of course, problem number 3. So problem number 3rd is completed, 4th and 5th and 6th, particularly these problems I need not to discuss here, already I said that. So they are annuity method and of course sinking method, both they have been deleted for the CA students. Definitely I can cover those depreciation fund and sinking fund as well as annuity methods for the all the remaining students in one more class. And because here the CA examinations are very near, and therefore I want to keep those topics for some time aside. Okay, now let us go to the illustration 7, machine hour rate method. What does it mean, machine hour rate method? Particularly sometime when you are able to say a particular machine can work this many number of hours and you can depreciate based on hours also. Say example, I bought a machine for 1 lakh rupees and I estimate that that machine may work for 1 lakh hours. Machine cost is 1 lakh, it works for 1 lakh hours. 1 lakh divided by 1 lakh, per hour 1 rupee is a depreciation. That's all. So in a particular year, how many years, how many hours that machine will work, based on that into 1 rupee, and you can depreciate that. So very simple to work out in this particular method. Okay, illustration 7 I can say. And first I want to say what is the depreciation formula in this particular one. So annual depreciation is equal to net cost of asset into net cost of asset, means cost of asset minus scrap value. I said that always scrap value should not be depreciated, because that is a balance left at the end of the lifetime. So cost of asset minus scrap value, which is net cost of asset, into in the numerator number of hours worked in an year, divided by total estimated hours of the machine. That's all. And that is a simple way to work out the annual depreciation in this particular method. Net cost of asset into number of hours worked in an year, divided by total estimated hours of the machine. So let us work out the illustration 7. A machine was purchased for 30 lakhs rupees having estimated value 24,000 total working hours. Scrap value is 2 lakhs. And anticipated pattern of distribution is given in the following manner. First of all, let us work out the depreciation 1 to 3 years. 1 to 3 years, it is expecting that 3 hours per year and that machine may work. Let us come to know annual depreciation. First, cost of asset 3 lakhs, cost of asset 3 lakhs into residual value 2 lakhs, which is net cost of asset 28 lakhs into number of hours worked for per year 3000, divided by total estimated hours of the machine is given at 24,000. Therefore, we can say here annual depreciation is equal to 3,50,000. What does it mean? This 350,000 is depreciation for the first, second, third, all the years together, or for each year? For each year, because that machine will work in first year 3,000 hours, second year 3,000 hours, even third year also 3,000 hours. So that 350,000 is the depreciation for not 1 to 3 years, only for each year. First year 350, second year 350, even third year also 350. Come to the next 4 to 6. 4th year, 5th year, 6th year and 7th year. Again it is same. 3 lakh minus 30 lakhs, sorry. This is not 3 lakhs. This is 30 lakhs, okay. 30 lakhs minus 2 lakhs into 2600 hours it can work per year, divided by 24,000. So each year and it can, the depreciation is 3,3333. Again that 3,3333 is the depreciation for the 4th year, 5th year, 6th year and even 7th year also same. Next come to 7 to 10 years. Same as 30 lakhs minus 2 lakhs into, right in the numerator it can work 1800 per hours divided by 24,000. The result here is 2,10,000. What does it mean 2,10,000? 2,10,000 is a annual depreciation which is applicable for 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th year also. 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, all the years, each year 2,10,000 is the depreciation. This is what we can say machine hour rate method. This method you can consider whenever you are able to say, and this machine can work for this many number of hours. Okay, and next one, illustration 8 we are going to discuss. Production units method. Production units method. And very simple to say this production units method. The only difference is in place of hour you can say unit, that's all. Earlier I said that you bought an asset and cost is 1 lakh and it can work 1 lakh hours, it can work per hour 1 rupee. But here we can say a machine I bought for 1 lakh rupees and it can produce 1 lakh units. 1 lakh divided by 1 lakh units, per each unit 1 rupee. So simply wherever you wrote earlier, this is quite common, net cost of asset. Number of hours means in place of hours you can write units. Total estimated hours means total estimated units, that's all. Everything is quite same. You replace the hours by units, that's all. Okay. Now let us see how to work out this particular one, illustration 8. A machine is purchased for 20 lakhs rupees. Its estimated useful lifetime is 10 years. Residual value is 2 lakhs. The machine is expected to produce 1.5 lakhs. Means 1,50,000 units during the lifetime. Expected distribution pattern of production is given like this, and very similar like earlier. Okay, so what we can say here, annual depreciation is equal to net cost of asset, which is cost of asset minus scrap value, into number of hours worked in an year. No, number of units produced in an year. Number of units produced in an year divided by total estimated units of that particular asset. Okay, now let us see how to work out here. Here also it is given 1 to 3 years first. Let us go for a net cost of asset, which is 20 lakhs minus 2 lakhs. 18 lakhs is the net cost of asset. In the numerator you can write 20,000 units it can produce. It can produce in an year, divided by total estimated units 1,50,000. Therefore, we can say annual depreciation is 2,40,000. Is it the 2,40,000 depreciation for 1 to complete 3 years? No, for each year 2,40,000 is the depreciation. For first year same, of course second year, even third year also. Come to 4 to 7. Same 20 lakhs minus 2 lakhs into, write in the numerator 15,000 units divided by 150,000 is equal to 180,000. This is what the annual depreciation, 180,000, which is applicable to 4, 5, 6 as well as 7th year. Lastly, 8 to 10. So, which is again 20 lakhs minus 2 lakhs into, it is given that 10,000 per each year divided by 1,50,000. So, that annual depreciation here is 1,20,000. This is for 8th year and of course 9th year and even 10th year also. And next we are going to discuss that depletion method. Okay. And what does it mean, depletion method? Of course, it is applicable to the natural resources. Depletion method, it is applicable to the natural resources like coal mines, minerals, etc. We can apply this. And I can say that depletion method is quite similar to the production units method. In formula and everything is quite similar. Okay, there is no any great difference to the production units method as well as depletion method. So we can discuss that illustration 9, depletion method. Depletion method, I can say this depletion method is applicable to the natural resources like coal mines, okay, and minerals and all that. And I said that it is formula, calculation, everything is quite similar to the production units method. Let us see how to handle the 9th one. Messrs. Surya took a lease, a quarry for 1 crore. As per technical estimate, total quarry minerals 2 lakh tons it can give. Depreciation was charged on the depletion basis and the pattern of mineral extracted given below. First, I would like to know that depreciation per ton here. Depreciation per ton we can say here. So net cost of asset into net cost, no scrap value is given. I'd like to say cost of assets straight away. This is 1 crore. 1 crore is the cost of asset. And I can produce 2 lakh tons. 1 crore divided by 2 lakhs. Okay, 5 zeros you can remove. 5 zeros you can remove. 250. That is 50 rupees per ton is the depreciation. So let us check that each year and how many units are produced. And in that way, and you can work out the asset account. And very, very simple to maintain the asset account. And so here, and you can maintain the quarry lease account. Quarry lease account, quarry lease account I would like to maintain. Let us see that how we are going to maintain. This is a very simple way to work out this quarry lease account. Yes, let us see that. First of all, so whenever it is purchased, it is actually quarry lease we have taken on 1/1/2013 for 1 crore. 1/1/2013. So quarry lease account data to bank account 1 crore. First year 31st December 2013 by depreciation. We know that 50 rupees per ton. 2000 tons we have taken. 2000 into 50 rupees. That is how much? 2000 into 50 rupees is 1 lakh. Okay. 1 lakh is the depreciation for first year. And simply we can go. Balance 1 crore and by balance carried on 99 lakhs. 1/1/2014 to balance brought down 99 lakhs. 31st December 2014 by depreciation again, this time let us check that how many units. 10,000 units are produced. 10,000 into 50 rupees, which is 5 lakhs. Let us balance this, 99 lakhs. 99 lakhs. By balance carried on, 94 lakhs. 11-2015, two balance brought down, 94 lakhs. 31st December 2015, by depreciation 15,000 tons are produced into 50 rupees, 7,50,000. Again by balance 94 lakhs. 94 lakhs. By balance carried on, two balance brought down, 86,50,000. Okay, and now lastly, you require to maintain the depreciation account also, and very simple to maintain the depreciation account. Let us see that depreciation account. So in the lease and by depreciation, in the depreciation, two lease, first year ending 2013 December 31st. So two quarry lease account, 1 lakh, and simply transfer to profit and loss account by P&L account. In the similar way, 2014 December 31st, two quarry lease, 5 lakhs. 2014 December 31st, by P&L, 5 lakhs. And 2015 December 31st, two quarry lease, 7,50,000. 2015 December 31st, by P&L, 7,50,000. That is a simple way to work out. In case of natural resources like coal mines, minerals, etc., this depletion method is applicable, and production unit method, and even depletion method, and these two are very similar. And regarding annual depreciation formula, there is no any great difference in the production unit method as well as depletion method. Now we can discuss the last problem for today, illustration 10. But here we are going to see that, so whenever asset is sold and how to so work out the machinery account, that's what we are going to discuss, no doubt, and here onwards. And these are all very important sums, particularly when sale has taken place and how to work out, so number of entries and all that we should know. Simply, when you buy the asset, of course asset account data to bank, from that day onwards you can depreciate that asset either by given SLM method or diminishing method, and whatever the method is given, it is given. Particularly till the date of sale, that asset is to be depreciated. Particularly whenever that asset is sold, we need to write three important entries. What are the three entries? So till the date of sale, that asset to be depreciated, depreciation to asset. When the asset is sold, entry bank account data to asset, cash or bank to asset. When there is, obviously when the asset is sold, you have to go to working notes, and we should work out what is the profit or loss on the sale of asset. How profit loss can be known? Take first of all original cost of asset and minus total depreciation. Depreciation total means from the beginning of the date to the date of sale, take the total depreciation and minus that. And we can say that is the written down value on the date of sale. And you can compare that written down value of asset and with the sale proceeds, and simply you can say the difference is like a profit or loss. If asset is sold more than written down value of asset on that day, that is a profit. If it is sold less than that, it is a loss. If there is a loss entry, P&L to asset. If there is a gain, asset to P&L. From that day onwards, and you can stop the depreciation of that asset because that is already sold away. Very, very simple to work out. Let us discuss that one here. Sale of asset we are going to discuss here. A firm purchased on 1/1/2015 a certain machinery, 1,82,000, and spent 18,000 on its erection. And erection charge is always like a capital expenditure. It is the part of asset. Therefore, 1/1/2015, when you buy the asset, asset account data to bank account. So 5,82,000 plus 18,000. So put together, that is what? 6 lakhs. The cost of asset is 6 lakhs. Okay. Right, what happened? On July 1st, 2015, during this year, in the middle of year, you bought one more asset at 2 lakhs rupees. Again, machinery to 1/7/2015, machinery to bank. This asset cost is 2 lakhs. So what happened? On July 1st, 2016, means in the next year middle, which is purchased on 1st January 2015, this machine in the next year middle sold at 3,86,000, and on the same day and a fresh machinery purchased at 4 lakhs rupees. This machine is sold in the next year middle, and on the same day we bought one more machine also. It is December 31st, books are closed every year. 10% should be depreciated on the written down value method. Okay. And during this year, and these two machines only we bought, nothing else. So let us depreciate at the end of year. So this is 31st December 2015. Depreciation account data to asset. In the asset by depreciation, first let us depreciate 6 lakhs into what is the percentage? 10%, which is 60,000. For complete year you need to depreciate. Whereas second asset, 2 lakhs into 10% into 6/12 only for 6 months. We utilized during this year 6 months. Okay, so that is what we can say, 10,000. 2 lakhs into 10%, 20,000. For half year, 10,000. Total depreciation, 70,000. So therefore, 8 lakhs by balance carry down, 7,30,000. 7,30,000. Bring that asset here. 1/1/2016. 2 balance brought down. 7,30,000. I said already this asset is exactly sold in the middle of year. 6 months late, after 6 months completion, this asset is sold. It is to be depreciated for 6 months during this year. And for sale proceeds, we need to write entry. And of course, loss or profit, we need to work out and we should record. First, let us depreciate for 6 months. So that is actually happened on July 1st. 1/7/2016 by depreciation. Within bracket, 6 lakhs minus 60, 5,40,000. 5,40,000 into 10% into 6 months, 6/12. Which is 27,000 is a depreciation for the asset sold. You can write whenever asset is sold, 3,86,000 bank to asset, and the asset by bank within bracket sale proceeds, which is 3,86,000. But we need to find out the profit loss. Go to the working notes, calculation of profit or loss on sale of machinery. Okay. First, I would like to take that. Cost of machinery sold, whatever the machinery sold right now, and what is the cost of that? 6 lakhs. Cost of the machinery sold, 6 lakhs minus total depreciation till the date of sale, 60,000 in first year plus 27,000 in second year, totally 87,000. Therefore, written down value on the date of sale is equal to 5,13,000. Written down value is 5,13,000 is the written down value. Sold for 3,86,000. 3,86,000. Definitely it is sold lesser than your book value. Therefore, the difference is loss. Loss on sale of machinery. Of course, the difference amount you need to take, which is 1,27,000. For that, we can write the entry. Loss always entry P&L to asset. And the asset by P&L. Within bracket loss. Okay. Which is 1,27,000. So, asset is depreciated for 6 months and the sale proceeds is recorded. The loss is also recorded. On the same day, and we bought one more machine. 1,7,2016. Two bank. So the latest machine whatever we purchased is 4 lakhs. And we need to depreciate that remaining asset. This asset, both to be depreciated at the end of year. 31st December 2016 by depreciation. Let us depreciate the first one. 2 lakhs. It was depreciated already by 10,000 rupees. 1,90,000. 90,000 into 10% complete year 19,000. Whereas latest asset we bought 4 lakhs into 10% into 6 months only, because you bought in the middle of year. 4 lakhs into 10% 40, for half year 20. Therefore, and it would be 39,000 depreciation for the second and third machines. Okay. Second as well as third machine put together 39,000. First machine already sold by you. That's all. No more entries. You can balance this. And 11,30,000 debit total. 11,30,000. So by balance carry down. To balance brought down. So here 5,51,000. 5,51,000, that is a balance carried down as well as brought down. By this way, whenever sale takes place and you can complete the machinery account. Okay. So now we discussed all the sums till 10th, and we can discuss the balance sums in the next class. Okay. So definitely, and these videos will be helpful to CA students undoubtedly. Even for all other students also we can use. And because I provided ICAI material link, and please go through that and so get the maximum benefit out of these videos. Okay, so we can discuss the next sum in the next class. Bye.